Good evening, everybody. Mike Vacchi, PrincetonTrader.com, here with your evening recap. Okay, I want to thank everybody who came out to the webinar tonight. That was fun. We did about an hour, and we'll do another one next month. I hope everybody takes advantage of the special offer there and comes and checks out the chat room for a couple of weeks. So, what are we looking at tonight? Okay, so we talked about how the market could not make this, you know, make its way back up to the middle band. It failed and failed hard. It tried to rally today and it didn't get it done. Between the middle band and the lower band is sell rallies land. Okay? You buy dips up here, you buy dips down here, you sell rallies in here. Okay? So, we got to see how tomorrow trades. We touched the lower Bollinger band yesterday. We did not touch it today. If we don't touch it tomorrow, then I'm going to start to become kind of in the bear flag camp, so to speak, versus a lower Bollinger band ride. Although this day sets up like a lower Bollinger band ride day, but it just didn't get that push to the downside. And any argument about a lower Bollinger band ride gets negated and you start really getting into bear flag mode if the market can take out today's high up at 39.25. So just understand, we're in sell rallies mode. Every time we get a rally, people are going to be all over the place saying it's over, not going down anymore, bulls got ahead of themselves. I mean, it was all over TV today. Everybody, well, you know, the bulls, they just, you know, they believed it yesterday, but now they're thinking about it. They're reevaluating their positions, and they're deciding that, you know, they don't really want to be short this mark. Come on, okay? I mean, just stop. I mean, the bears do the same thing. We're running up on highs. You know, the bulls are nervous, and they don't. You don't know. I don't care who you work for. You don't know. The reality is, you've got to get out of your head and get on the chart. Get out of, you know, thinking, you know, it's that old line from Bull Durham. Don't think. It'll only hurt the ball club. You got to stop that. You got to trust your work. You got to trust the hours you put in at night. You got to trust your levels. And you got to trust your chart. And, you know, if that work is solid, then it will tell you where to go, and it will tell you what to do when you get there. It's just, you know, it's a matter of preparation. But the speculation about what everybody's thinking, and, you know, that's all hope, and it just doesn't work. So tomorrow we got GDP, we got jobless claims. If it upsets the market, I could see us pushing down. I have a hard time seeing tomorrow, no matter what the news is, really getting below 16.18, 16.19, you know, let's say 17 to 19 area. If we bounce, I really think the market does have a bounce to 47 in it to test that fib and fail. You know, and then you've really just got a series of lower highs developing. Okay, here's this little quick and dirty trend line from this lower high where we broke to here. You start seeing a trend line developing that over time we could see a drift back up to 47. That would be kind of the bull flag camp. We certainly could get the declining volume that you would get in a bull in a bear flag, rather. Not, I keep saying bull flag, bear flag. And then you kind of see a dump out. We'll have to see. You know, and at the same time, and I'll give you the preview of coming attractions, you know, for next week. If we keep making lower highs and bleeding out, and if the bleeding out accelerates into jobs, then you're pretty much going to see jobs as a bullish catalyst. It'll probably pop the market. At the same time, if we do a slow drift from this low, say we make a low tomorrow, or say that the low today, the 24, that really was a low. If we start to drift and grind higher towards Friday, then you start looking at the jobs as a catalyst for the next leg down. Okay? So, you know, that's just planning out the chart with respect to, you know, major economic events that are coming within the next week. Now, all that sounds great, except you've got Syria in the middle of it, which is just a complete and total wild card question mark, and could send the market in either direction depending on what we do. So this is not an easy market to navigate. Be aware of the headlines, but stay on the chart. Don't overthink it. And, you know, when things start to exhaust, when you start to see this action, we had the high here, this 5-minute chart. Make that high around noontime. We go down and we test 32. As we get back up here, everybody's looking higher. Everybody's looking higher. But then we go ahead and just give it up after 2 o'clock. And there's only so many, you know, you got a lower high. That's 2 consecutive lower highs. That tells you you're not getting that push that you would get if the bulls were in charge. And the bears keep controlling the closes. They keep controlling the closes. Just about every close is controlled by the bears. And that's always a tell of who's really in control of the market. Okay, everybody have a great night. Check out Twitter. Check out the chat room. And I will catch everybody in the morning with a pre-market webcast. Trade them well.